Welcome back. Well, we reported to you last week that emerald ash borer has been identified in another Minnesota county.
Yeah, the invasive species was recently discovered in Kennebec County, which is the 47th Minnesota county that it's reached. Angie Ambourn is a plant protection expert from the Minnesota Department of Agriculture. She joins us live via Zoom this morning to explain what's going on. Angie, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks for having me.
So what do you know about this recent discovery?
So the recent discovery in Kennebec was just another county that, EAB is starting to spread, emerald ash borer, is starting to spread, further north as we start looking for it outside of kind of the generally infested area, which is kind of that seven metro county area and the southeast part of the state. And so we do a lot of survey, and these points outside of that area just keep popping up. I mean, it's really spreading now.
Okay, so there's something called an MDA emergency quarantine when it comes to this. What does that mean, and who does it impact?
So the quarantine is put in place to really slow the spread of emerald ash borer. The emergency quarantine means we're just waiting right now through that public comment period before the formal quarantine goes in. So right when we find it, usually we put in a emergency quarantine, and that's until we can get through the full formal process until it's formally quarantined. And what that means is it just means that there's restrictions on what you can move in terms of, the insect itself, firewood, those types of things. And so if people want to move, especially firewood and or ash, they should probably reach out to the Minnesota Department of Agriculture and find out what, where they're moving and what the regulations are and how it would impact them. And we have regulatory experts that can answer all those questions.
So we talk about this quite often when this conversation comes up about the transportation of the firewood. Is firewood from other parts of the state what is ultimately helping to spread the ash borer, or do they sort of move naturally as well?
So they do move naturally, but anytime you see kind of a larger jump in that spread, that's typically a human-assisted movement. And one of the most common ways that emerald ash borer moves is through the movement of firewood. And so we really want to encourage people, not to take firewood out of the quarantines counties into quarantine or into non-quarantine counties. And you can find all of that information on the MDA website on our map. And so, that really comes down as to, not taking firewood up to your cabin, buying firewood where you're at, cutting it at, on your property, your recreational property. And so we just really want to push that message of being, responsible, outdoor enthusiasts in the state.
For people who have ash trees in their yard, on their property, they know this. They probably think about this, like, will I have this problem too? What should they know? How can they make sure that they keep ash out of their trees?
So if you have an ash tree and you go online and you look and you're in that generally infested area, you're in one of those counties, you really want to start thinking about what you're going to do with your ash tree. And I would recommend that if you want to keep that ash tree in your yard and it's important to you, you get that treated. And there's lots of good, insecticides out there for treating your tree for emerald ash borer. And it's really important that people, call a reputable company, that they get someone to come out to make sure that their tree actually has emerald ash borer, and that they're using a product that is in line with, what they would like to do in their yard. There are some chemicals that are not as pollinator friendly, for example. And so if you have a pollinator yard, that's something that you want to keep in mind. And so really getting yourself a professional that knows what they're doing is super important.
How do you know what to look out for if you've got ash trees in your yard? How do you know you've got these things?
That you have it. So, I mean, there's a lot of signs and symptoms. You'll see woodpecker damage on your trees. You might start to see some thinning canopy. It is getting more and more common now to see the adults, but that's not typical. You're really kind of, this time of year, if you can see these areas where the woodpeckers are kind of going at the top part of your tree, that's kind of one of the big signs. That being said, if you suspect you have it, you should probably, get someone out to look at your tree.
As far as the spread, I do have a question about this because it seems like you're concerned of them moving from southern parts of the state to the north. Did they come here from another part of the country? Did they move up north sort of to get into Minnesota in the first place?
You mean how they got to Minnesota in the first place? We're going on 15 years of when the first find was. It was in 2009, I believe. So they don't actually know how it came in to the state. It came into the country, they think, on solid packing material. And then it's just kind of been moving through the movement of, some of it natural spread, but through the movement of firewood and those kinds of things. And it's been moving its way west ever since. It was first found in the Detroit area.
Okay, moving east to west, got it.
We hear, kind of to wrap this up, we hear a lot about emerald ash borer. This is not something new that we haven't thought about, but there are some other species, invasive species, that are in Minnesota. Anything else we should be looking out for?
One of the other big ones that, we're dealing with right now is the spongy moth, and that is one that we would like, people to report. There's a couple that are close. There's the spotted lanternfly, which is as close as, Cook County and Chicago, in the Chicago area. So those are all ones that people, should be on the lookout for. So just, things like checking out the plants you buy. If you're buying a tree, if you're buying nursery stock, checking them out. If you've been traveling to areas where there are those invasive species and you've been camping, checking on your campers before you come back into the state. There's a lot of things that we can do as residents just to kind of help, keep our state as clean as possible.
Great.
Excellent, Angie. Well, thanks for joining us today. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Angie.
Yeah, no problem. Have a great day.
Super informative. Mm-hmm. Things I did not know.